death toll continues to rise in Gaza. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says Palestinian militants are going to pay a heavy price for their rocket attacks on Israel. A building in Gaza City has gone up in flames following a series of attacks by Israel. For insight and analysis, we're joined on Newsnight by the Vice President for the Media Review Network, Aisha Soni. Ms. Soni, good evening, and thanks for coming in. The Health Ministry in Gaza estimates the current death toll from the Israeli air and sea strikes at 86. Large numbers of civilians are among the dead, the IDF confirming 320 targets hit overnight. What is your assessment of the current standoff?
Okay, well, firstly, thank you for having me. When you look at the numbers, so just 86 civilians, I think 86 people killed, I think a lot of people think that those are civilians. If we had a look at the statistics, a total of 9 of those are active militants. We have 22 children, including 13 women, who have been massacred over the last 4 days. There have been more than 500 injured, 70 houses demolished. And so we can see the situation is very bad. We can see an evident example of what Israel is best at doing, and that's collective punishment of a civilian population. We saw it in 2009, Operation Castle, 2012, Operation Pillar of Defense, and again we've seen it now, which is absolutely disproportionate and unacceptable.
Let's talk about Benjamin Netanyahu defending the strike, saying Hamas and others in Gaza are firing rockets on cities throughout the state of Israel, and to quote him saying no country on earth would remain passive in the face of hundreds of rockets fired on its cities. Do you believe, and I think you've alluded to it now, that Israel has reacted to this disproportionately?
If we look at the Hamas rockets and looking at the history going back to it, we can't go back to the Hamas rockets a month, a few years, a few intifadas ago. We have to go back to the very root of this problem. And the root of this problem is 66 years of occupation of Israel by Palestinian land. But not going into that history, we can go into the events that unfolded recently now, because if we had to talk about the various massacres, what that Israel has perpetuated over the years, we could be here forever. So Israel says that now they are retaliating in return to Hamas rockets. Firstly, that's a lie. Israel did break the ceasefire that was put in place in 2012. Secondly, they say that this is in response to 3 Israeli teens who were on an illegal Israeli settlement being killed. If we look at that, from 2000 until 2013, 1,518 Palestinian children have been killed by Israel, making it a Palestinian child killed every 3 days by Israel. So obviously I'm not condemning the killing of any children in any conflict, but if we're looking at retaliatory, then it's not Israel that's retaliating, it's more the resistance of the Palestinian people against the occupation.
Actually, for people who are observing this, I mean, as you say, 66 years, there's quite a bit of religious and political baggage, and depending on who you speak to, every side seems to make a strong argument for their position. No, they started first. No, we started first. I mean, what is it going to take to fix this, especially in the face of so many dead, and as you pointed out, so many children dead? We've had, many UN resolutions. We've had many talks across the Arab nations. We've had, ceasefire agreements, the one that you alluded to. What is it going to take to break the back of of what's happening in the Middle East and find a resolution?
Okay, so firstly, I don't see this. You have to step aside from the religious and the political. When you see the situation in Gaza, this is a humanitarian crisis. And what is going on, innocent people are being massacred, entire families are being annihilated. And that's a humanitarian crisis because Zionism, the Israeli state dictated by Zionism, is perpetuating massacres and the world is remaining silent. So what we can do in terms of mass mobilization, I think that's a step that we could take. But in terms of the South African government, I think boycott, divestment and sanctions is the way to go, because that is how apartheid South Africa was brought down, and that is how the Zionist apartheid state of Israel will be brought down ultimately.
What about the Arab states and the United Nations?
The Arab states have had a deafening silence. I know George Galloway was very prominent and outspoken about this, and that is very disappointing. I mean, Egypt has a border with Gaza. If they open the Rafah border, they could alleviate a lot of the suffering of Gaza, who's been under siege for the last 8 years. So that is a problem. I'm not condoning what the Arab leaders are doing at all. They have a huge part to play, but at the moment they aren't stepping up. Neither are the United Nations. They're implementing all of these UN resolutions, but Israel hasn't listened to 47 UN resolutions, so that isn't a step. I think boycott, divestment and sanctions is the future for how we are going to stop Israel, because every time they do this, we have mass mobilizations, we have protests, we have vigils, and yet they continue the massacres.
Aisha Soni, I'm afraid we're out of time. Thank you very much for coming in. We appreciate yours. Aisha Soni is the Vice President for the Media Review Network.